I'm Greg Calbi from Sterling Sound here in the Chelsea Market in New York. The first step that I take every single time is I have a preset in my Ozone, which is kind of like a standard preset. And that standard preset I will immediately shoot out with my other outboard digital setup. This way I can kind of understand what is affected positively with ozone and what is affected negatively. If I get a sense that the ozone direction is going to work, I then can go in and use the presets and kind of shoot them out with each other. The main thing about the presets that I've developed is that you got to think of them as a starting point, not as an ending point. They're like a window into where a mix can go as an intermediate stage to finishing a mastering. Think of them almost as separate genres or separate concepts, but it gives you an entrance way into something that you can manipulate further. Do not think of those presets as something that you can just magically put on something and make it sound good. They're completely dependent on the mixes. They're completely dependent on the recording. They're the best, by far, the best plugins that I've found to maintain dynamics at the levels that we need to work at. They're really good. I've very rarely seen anything even close to how easy these are to tune and to work with. They are deep. There's plenty to play with. If you're a professional and there's a time constraint, that you'd approach them with one level. If you're an amateur recordist and you want to learn and you want to see what mastering can do, it's just plain fun because there's more toys in there that you can play with and learn about and easily be able to make your own. They're a jumping off point. Ones that I've worked on that I use, but understand that I use them as a starting point too. I don't use them as a finishing point. It's really very quick and easy to kind of take a stab at a certain type of compression and capture it and then A-B it with another one of the presets. And like all compression, of any kind of compression, you have got to compare things at exactly the same level. Anything louder will usually sound better. It'll be deceptive. So, you know, the gain structure on the output stage of the maximizer is very, very accurate. So a tenth of a dB makes it really easy to manipulate the total gain, and the graphics are very, very user-friendly. So I can really do these comparisons. Going back to that original mix is really so important. I would encourage anybody that does mastering to keep the original mix in mind and make sure that you listen to that original mix at the level of your mastering, or reduce the level of your mastering so you actually hear, independent of level, musically what you're doing to the blend, because the ear is not going to be listening to level after a while. The ear is going to be listening to the music and what the blend is. Having Ozone, the availability and the flexibility of the plugin certainly makes the job a lot easier in terms of walking out of here at night knowing that you did the best thing that you could.